Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Miss World Canada 2013.
I wear my heart up on my sleeve like the big deal. Your love pours down on me, surround me with a waterfall. There's no stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now.
It's a special night. I want the entire Canada to know what this pageant is all about. All these girls for the past 6-7 months across the country, they have been actively raising funds to bring a change in the life of children. Some go to universities, and they have two jobs, their family, their boyfriends. And out of that, if you see, you'll get tears in your eyes how they raise funds. So please, again, give your hands for this girls. Two years ago, when I was asked to take over the pageant, of course, they wanted to run now pageants as a business and, you know, take it a little bit far. So of course, as a business person, I asked the question, what is our mission statement? One was raising funds, so that was very touching. But the second one is to empower young women to reach their potential. So my question is, how do we do that? So the answer I got that, well, it's up to them. We help them get state skills, we take them here, and one person wins. My next question was, then what happens to the rest of the girl that don't win? Well, they go back home. After that, what happens to them? Nothing, we start the new pageant. Honestly, for my entire life, even my parents, we've been involved in different charities. But for some reason, that didn't make sense to me. This is all about empowering one winner. What happens to the other girls? So I made some changes. I brought three important changes, and I'll be very quick about this. The first one was that when these candidates join our organization, they become part of the organization and stay in the Miss World Canada roster as long as they want. So that's one thing. They get a permanent title, which is their name, followed by Miss World Canada Delegate 2013. They get their own email. They get their own Miss World Canada Facebook that they keep it for life. Then the next thing happens, and this is what our plan is, some of the candidates from last year and this year and next year, they'll be working on projects all united together all across the country to help humanity. So, this year, They worked on about 23 combined projects. And if you look in the Facebook, you know the pageant industry is very individualistic. They all work alone, they don't work together. This is, I was so thrilled when I saw them working together with the project, all united, all having fun, right? The second thing I did is I introduced some of the worldwide known coaches. One here is Dale Carnegie Institute, Dale Carnegie Training. Now, in my university years, Dale Carnegie, I was a student. Years ago, just imagine I'm old now, right? So this is worldwide. It's the highest level of education you can get in leadership. Then you have Anthony Robbins, you have Christopher Howard, you have Deepak Chopra, and a whole bunch of worldwide known coaches. So every week, all these girls receive something from us, and she gets it from Lynette. You'll meet her. She's our director of delegate development. She's getting an award tonight. So they get this, they spend 10, 15 minutes learning, and every week they get this. And then they respond back. So we know they're really following that education. And then we have a small marketing department that markets to the film industry. So we have connected with some people in the film industry that are helping us with this. Entertainment industry and the corporate world. We showcase the talents and the skills to open the doors for better opportunities in the future. Now I can proudly say to all the Canadians, yes, we empower these young women. We don't leave anybody behind. I want all of you here tonight to thank you for coming and supporting us for this event. And you don't know how much it means to all these girls to see you clap hands and encourage all these things. But I also want a promise from you today that I want you to go to all the Canadians and tell them really what Miss World Canada is all about. Because they see people, they think this is a pageant. Girls march on the stage and we choose the most beautiful girl. This is not what we do. So thank you very much for your support. Thank you very much for every beat that you have done for us.
Five men and women. A lot of pressure on you guys tonight. How about a round of applause for the judges first? Gonna be tough.
Would you tell us your name and why you are so excited to be here tonight?
I'm Natalie. I'm Marie Francisco, and I'm excited to be here because I am going to help pick somebody who's going to be representing Canada.
Everyone, a wave.
First off, thank you for being here. Tell us your name and how excited you are to be here tonight with all these beautiful ladies and a great crowd behind you.
Thank you, everyone. Good evening. This is my third time in Miss Canada judge. I very enjoy it, but it's very tough for us to choose anyone. And I hope you guys help me too. Thank you. Enjoy the show.
Thank you, Sandra. Now we have a sports guy. What are you doing here in a beauty pageant?
I'm not sure, but I'm super excited to be here. My name is Dan Caldwell. I'm president and co-founder of a sports brand called Tap Out. We have offices all over the world, including Canada. And I'm really excited to see these women, these young women come out here and step outside of their comfort zone. And one of these young women are really going to be, their lives are going to change forever. And that's, can't wait to see that.
Well, that my mic's working. I'm also excited to be surrounded by so many beautiful women behind me, in front of me. This is new to me. Usually I'm in like a locker room with sweaty dudes, so this is awesome. Tell us about your name, why you're here, and how excited you are to be a judge. Or are you excited? How nervous are you?
I'm nervous and excited. My name is Nicole Watson. I'm an actress living in Los Angeles now, from Vancouver, Canada. I'm very excited to be part of this event. Because it's not only beauty, but beauty with a purpose. And these girls are doing positive impact work that will affect the world. And we're in the process of deciding who will represent Canada, which is very exciting.
Nicole, I gotta call you out on something, though. You've been gone too long. Vancouver, Canada? We're, you know. I love it, though. That was cute, though. I'm so mean.
Are you all done? Okay, great. So now we meet the host of last year's Miss World Canada, Veronica. Tell us about
myself. Hi, everyone. How's everyone doing tonight? I can't really see you, but I want you guys to make some noise. Get on your chairs. Make a lot of noise because these ladies are nervous, but they are so charismatic. They have so much talent, and they have so much to give this nation and to represent this country of Canada, right? College, and I host Bollywood Boulevard on Omni TV and City TV, and I'm so excited to be here in Vancouver simply because the weather is so beautiful and you guys are so beautiful, and tonight's gonna be a good night, right? And these girls need a lot of cheers and a lot of love, so I'm so happy you guys could all be here.
Give her a hand, because she actually gave us a lot of tips on how not to screw this up tonight and get fired.
Apparently we're not taking any of those tips, Ryan.
Even though it's volunteer, they can still fire me, I've heard.
Well, we're still here.
Well, good day, it's early, right? I haven't put my swimsuit on
we'll
yet.
We'll check that into my
shirt. Right. How excited are you to be here? Introduce yourself to this crowd. How excited are you for these young ladies? Someone that's going to be Miss Canada.
Hello, everyone. I'm Robin. From the Housewives of Vancouver. Don't hold that against me, please. I am so excited to be here and be a part of selecting Miss Canada. This is a big, big honor, and I hope you guys enjoy yourself, and it's a pleasure being here and meeting all of you guys too. Thank you.
Thank you guys so much. I was actually, I'm looking at, we should talk because I want to launch a new show, Desperate Husbands of Boyle.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks to the judges in the preliminary competition, I'm able to perform here for you tonight. I'll be playing a song that's composed by a practitioner of Falun Gong, a spiritual practice that has been brutally persecuted in China for the past 14 years. The song commemorates those who have lost their life for their faith and praises the millions of people who continue their peaceful resistance even till today. I'd like to dedicate this song to my father, who's sitting in the audience with us today, whom I was not able to see for 9 years of my life because of my human rights activism. I'm glad that he can see with his own eyes today about how we Canadians fight for their freedom. Thank you very much. Thank you.
and gentlemen, oh my goodness, round of applause for them. And my apologies. We should also mention, Tamara, you're still the People's Choice Award, so congratulations. That's one thing I need to say. In fourth place, Katie Zapari. The second runner-up, Tamara Jemovich. Yeah!